We are following breaking news out of Haiti. The largest and most powerful earthquake in the region's history has crippled the country, measuring 7 points.
We must get help because our people are dying.
The situation is beyond desperate at this point.
Two 747s arrived in Port-au-Prince from Israel, one loaded with medical supplies and the other with personnel, here to create the best field medicine available.
This is like another world compared to the other hospital. It's just amazing.
Israel's tragic experience as a target of terrorism has given it unparalleled expertise responding to catastrophic emergencies. It's a skill that the Jewish state has brought to disaster scenes around the globe. But Israel's legacy of humanitarianism can be traced all the way back to its founding. Pioneering leaders reached out to help other developing nations. Chaim Devon runs the Israeli government's aid programs.
Israel is kind of a living laboratory, a model of success of a country that met the challenges in spite of very difficult conditions, not only very difficult climatic conditions, but they're very difficult political conditions.
Israel has shared its know-how in areas ranging from groundbreaking drip irrigation techniques to community development with 140 nations.
I'm Dominique Kwadio. I come from Côte d'Ivoire, Ivory Coast in West Africa.
And I'm from Nigeria, Sierra Leone.
I'm from Rwanda. I came from Ethiopia.
At its headquarters in Haifa, and in workshops held around the world, the Golda Meir Ear Center has worked with women in developing countries for nearly half a century. Mazel Renford heads the center.
We want to empower women. This is a main objective, main goal of this center. We want to help the poorest of the poor at the grassroots level in one hand, and we want to also to help the women to reach the highest level possible.
One of those women is Yuruti Mendez from Paraguay. Yuruti turned the skills she learned from her Israeli training into a successful family business.
What Israel taught me was that you could do everything out of nothing. They taught me in real experiences, in hand-on experiences, that this can be done.
So inspired was Yuruti by what she learned from Israel that today she travels throughout the poorest countries in Latin America teaching other women those same techniques.
Something very important I learned from Israel is that you don't have to keep what you learned for your own. You have to give it to someone else.
Yeruti hopes that in the process, she may change the negative perception many in that part of the world have of Israel.
I think they don't know the Israel that I know, and the collaboration and the great things that Israel gave to my life. There's not many people in the world that come to you and tell you, I'm here to help you.
In Africa, Israeli training programs are helping lift entire communities. Places like Kumasi, Ghana, where just 50% of the population receives a formal education. Abina Botang spearheads the educational development programs there.
A lot of these kids ended up dropping out from school even before they completed the 6 years of primary education. And when you have kids dropping out of school, it means that you don't have the required manpower to be able to fill in the slots that you need to develop your country.
Abina, a veteran of numerous Israeli training programs, turned once again to the Jewish state for help.
I probably will have some questions.
Israel has been a partner for Ghana many, many years, even in our colonial days. We found in Israel a group of people who had the know-how and who do not just encourage the country to just adopt, but rather to adapt whatever they learn to suit the systems within their country.
She took what she learned and modernized the city's teacher training system. Within a short time, Kumasi's student dropout rate began shrinking.
Because of the training that we have acquired from Israel, I see a very bright future for Kumasi. and the rest of the country.
In Nigeria, the life expectancy for women is only 48 years. That's why Nigerian OBGYN Gerald Nwocha went to Israel for advanced medical training.
I was posted to Wofsin Medical Center to work under Professor Golan, whom I think is one of the experts in laparoscopy in Israel.
This less invasive surgical procedure removes tumors and cysts while reducing the risk of infection and shortening patient recovery time. Dr. Nwocha wanted to learn this technique in order to save women's lives in his country.
You don't get that training in Nigeria at all.
But in Israel, Dr. Nwocha received much more than advanced medical training.
Before I went to Israel, I didn't really know anything about it except what I read in newspapers of war and conflict. I'm glad a day has finally come for me to bear witness to the world how the state of Israel rewrote the history of my life and that of many others.
Helping other nations is an integral pillar of Israel's national identity.
We, the Jewish people, we know what does it mean when we have been abandoned. And we also know what it is when countries and communities assisted us. So we know more than anyone else, and better than anyone else, what it means to share and to care.
For me, it's a very, very important component of our life. We should share with others what we have.
This is part of our culture, this is part of our philosophy, this is part of our being.